Hello, fellas. I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill. And I was thinking, what we can play after yesterday fail for you. Since the games with a 4:30 bucket went very, very, very bad. I thought, okay, today we are going to play with a heavy tank, which people is not talking too much. It is 50 TP Tyshkevich, right? Polish tier 9 vehicle. And I actually like it. It's not bad vehicle, especially when you are playing hold down and when you are using your gun depression. The weak spot is obviously Coppola. And overall tank is not so bad. When you are side scrapping, you have chance to miss the shot or two. And our average performance with this vehicle is 3.1 plus. Plus 700, because we recently played with it, and it is decent performance in my opinion. So what we are going to do, my lovely friends, we are going to play two or three battles, depends how games will go with this tank, and hopefully we are going to have a good games. Hopefully we are going to have a good matchmaking, which apparently we already do, and hopefully it's going to be enjoyable gaming experience overall. At least that's what I'm hoping for. And obviously, if you are owning Tyshkevich, if you have one or you played with one, always feel free to leave your opinions down below, so people which is either thinking going through this vehicle is going to see, and you are going to help a lot of people, not only me, and I'm enjoying reading your comments. Obviously I can't read them all, but if you are finding the heart next to your comment, that basically means I read it. That's how I am marking the comments which I read, okay? So, what we are going to do there, there is a couple of Jeffs, which is unfortunate, but not much what we can change right here. And I am thinking about simply going like this, right? This is my main plan and my main mission. Now look, this is kind of risky thing, but if I will take this position over there, we are going to feel like a kings, because it's just amazing position to play in. What is the downside of this position? Obviously Jeffs, and obviously people which can play over there, but it's going to be interesting, at least I hope so. Ooh, Lynx is going with a high explosives, not a big deal, and we have a first victim, which is a prototype. Obviously, Jeff is hitting us for 300, not a big deal, not the first time, not the last time. And you know what, we notice that they have actually so many forces over there, it's actually crazy. But what do we want to do, my lovely friends? We want to advance, we want to go in front, and we simply want to deal with this Mr. Pilot, right? So we are going in front, and Pilot notice that he screwed up, okay? So what we are going to do, we are going to bang him in the wall, and he is getting killed right there. Beautiful. Now we are Arta safe, and now we can actually play the game. Now you might wonder, but Skill, what you are planning to do? You see those guys over there? I am thinking about punishing those guys which is playing over there in the side, if everything will go well, right? That's what I want to do, my lovely friends. So wait for it, wait for it, wait for it. It might go very, very, very well. Schnei in the face. 580 pixel shot. I'm telling you, this vehicle is decent. This vehicle is nice. You can hit quite complicated shots, and you can punish enemies if they are doing something stupid. And for now, it's looking very, very good. The main reason why it's looking good so far is very, very simple. As you can see, our team is controlling this side, and enemies locked themselves into the castle, because pushing like this from their side is not going to be very, very rewarding, right? At least I don't really think it's going to be very rewarding. Now, what I'm thinking about doing, how about a bit side scrapping over there, Tyshkevich. Enemy Tyshkevich just shot, obviously he did not penetrate us, which was very good thing for us. And there is IS-3 which is waiting till we are going to peek soon. And we are peeking Russia. Good, good trade. 640 in the face. I'm getting lucky with the rolls. Why am I saying that? It's very, very simple. Because we have 560 alpha damage, okay? Another one. Hi there, honey. I hope you are well. 530 in the face, and you can side scrap with this vehicle. It's not horrible as a tank at all, my lovely friends. I would say it is actually nice as a tier 9. Obviously, it's not the best tank in the world of tanks, but it's not bad whatsoever. Here you go, fire to IS-2. And he is taking one for the team, which is just beautiful for us. Do we want to hit the IS-3? Absolutely yes. He is waiting for us sideways and we are punishing him for his stupidity, which is very, very good. Now, wait for it. 50 TP might try to peek like this. Meanwhile, defender is going piri-piri through the open field. And this is actually very good stuff for us. What do we want to do for this Mr. Defender? We want to build the angle from where we could punish him for his mistakes. Right? That's what we want to do. And now wait for it. This is not that good as angle as I thought it's going to be, my lovely friends. Okay, not a big deal. Not a big deal at all. So what we are doing, we are going to side scrap against the enemy Tishkevich once again. We have all time in the world of tanks, so patience is the key right there, right? Russia. Unfortunately, we did not manage to punish him over there. Plus, on top of that, I noticed that we have an advantage over this guy. You might think, but skill, what kind of advantage? Well, he is stock. And this is a huge advantage for us, right? So what we are doing, we are going to make a pressure just like this in front. And now, first things first, what we want to do, we want to destroy this IS-3. There is literally a pixel where we can penetrate, and we are going to ask for some luck over there, if I can say so, right? He's thinking about peeking. I'm pretending I'm not looking at him, and he is going to peek in approximately couple of seconds. Is he? Oh yes. Obviously Tishkevich managed to penetrate us with a what the flying F. Why the F he rolled us that high? Or maybe I was fool? Could be very, very possible, fellas. Could be very, very possible. Anyways, no complaints, no regrets. I made a mistake. Apparently, I was looking into the IS-3 alpha damage. That was not Tishkevich. Tishkevich have a good gun. Whoopsie, my mistake. It happens sometimes. Once again, boys, it is happening sometimes. So this guy is thinking about making a pressure for us, and I am feeling extremely, extremely, extremely well. So now we are going to dance with the devil right here, which is completely fine, and we are going to start banging him right there, right? Now I want to face hug him. I know it's not the best option, but in the same time, I'm trying to block his gun. I am putting my gun into his gun, and I'm expecting for the best. Although probably he was armor reactive, and he got completely destroyed for his mistake. That was a beautiful game in my opinion. Obviously, for Tishkevich, for this nutty boy, we loaded the gold ammunition in the end just to eliminate him from the game, and that was probably the most important shots of the game, I would say. So that was beautiful. Apart one mistake which I have done in this battle, and my mistake was to... I was overestimating my powers a bit. I am saying this wrong. Sorry. You know what was my mistake? My biggest mistake was I did not realize that Tishkevich have a top gun, okay? Either way, that was not a horrible game by any means. We did everything properly and I am very, very happy with this performance. This should be ace wanker in my opinion. 5,500 damage, 2,200 assisting damage, solid 7,000 combined. Beautiful game, fellas. Cheers. Very nice. Very good game. It was risky play though. Because Centurion could punish me while I'm getting into this position. Artas could punish me, which they actually did, and everything. Either way, solid ace wanker. I am very, very, very happy about this performance. Comparing to the yesterday's video, 432. Very good performance. Very nice. Okay, let's go for at least one more battle and maybe we are going to reach 100% on the Tishkevich. That would be very, very nice. But we'll see. Time is going to show everything. Don't be overexcited, by the way. To not drop down, we need 3,700. Beautiful. Okay. What do we have? We have the corridor pass. Wherever you are going, corridors everywhere. And it is ideal map for a heavy tanks, to be honest. So I'm not complaining about this whatsoever. I'm trying to figure out, my lovely friends, what do I want to do? What do I want to do? My first and initial thought was maybe go over there and just chill, but it's not bringing you victory. It's this is the road for a damage, let's say like that. And I don't care about the damage at all, I care about victory, right? So what we are going to do right there, I think our main plan is going to be to think about the ice field, okay? The main reason why am I saying so is very simple. As you can see, we do not have literally anyone over there, which is completely fine. And what I want to do, my lovely friends, I want to take a safe defense parameter over there, okay? I hope enemies are going to make a pressure like this, and then we are going to simply bang them and punish them for their stupidity and so on, so on, so on. I don't want to follow the lemming train, because if everything would go bad, right? If enemies is having three guns which is going like this, entering into the cap, maybe no one is going to come back, right? I'm thinking about this kind of strategy. Obviously, time will show everything, and maybe this is a huge mistake from my side, right? You never know. Plus, on top of that, the question is how fast enemies are going to react into our lemming train. Is enemies going to make a pressure like this? Yes or no? We don't have camo. They might outspot us. So there is quite some bad things which might happen over there. But still, we have all time in the World of Tanks, so just chill and relax. Sometimes the most important thing is to have a good position. ML2 went over there, as you can see, via the ice road, but now he's sitting in the deep shithole. Why am I saying his shithole is very, very deep over there? Because we have a lot of bushwankers. Those bushwankers can simply shit on him if he is making some kind of pressure over there, which is very good. Meanwhile, we notice that the E5, which is going like this, it's completely fine. You think I'm afraid? Not at all. I'm not afraid at all. Meanwhile, we have the flat side of the E5 and we are trying to punish him. We did that successfully, and the E5 is shooting high explosives, which is actually laughable and very, very funny, right? Very good. How about this guy? Can we penetrate him? Absolutely not. How dare I? Okay. Good, fellas, good. This is actually insanely good situation for us. As you can see, we were patient, we was waiting until the enemies are going to make a pressure, and they actually did. Very good. Now I was a bit impatient over there, but it doesn't matter. That was terrible shot, unfortunately, by me. It happens. Mistakes is happening from time to time, and I messed up right there. Doesn't matter. How about this E5, which is making a pressure like this? Can we see him going sideways like this? Because there is a big chance and big possibility. Wait for it. Wait for it. Wait for it. Wait for it. Patience, fellas. Be patient. And here we go. Beautiful penetration into the frontal mantlet. Why so? Because his angle was completely flat for us, so that's why we penetrated him, right? Meanwhile, the guy is shooting high explosives, so what it's saying for us, he doesn't know what he is doing over there, and we are simply searching the right angle to penetrate him and to punish him for his mistakes, right? Which is completely fine, boys and girls, which is completely fine. Meanwhile, this guy, as you can see, he's looking at us. Do I care about it? Not at all. We have all time in the World of Tanks. Now we are going to punish this guy once again, just like this, but we need to build a good angle. How we are going to do this? By sliding down, because I'm brave. So we slid it down a bit, and it was not enough, so I decided to slide even more. And I was not feeling like I am challenged enough over there, so I decided to go a bit more aggressive, okay, against the enemies. Nothing too crazy. Meanwhile, the RNG treated me kind of well over there, and I got penetrated. I missed the direct shot into this guy, plus on top of that, he high rolled for 550. Well, what can you do? Cry every time. That was a stupid slip by me, obviously. That was my mistake, and I could play with this battle so much better. That was very, 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 very bad play. But in the end of the day, this decision for us to sit over there, it was not awful, as you can see. Because we did not have any forces which played over there, we simply had a safe defense parameter and we farmed a bit, obviously. This farmed a bit is not too much because it could be so much better, but this greediness syndrome. I want to go in front, I want to farm damage, just simply killed me. Oh well, what can you do? Better luck next time. Obviously, we are going to have the third battle right here. Hopefully, this time I'm not going to fail like a pigeon, right? So yeah, that was a good one. Anyway, see you in a second when this battle is going to be over. Peace. And we are back. Well, remember what did I saw? What did I said before? If enemies will cap base, I definitely throw at this battle by dropping down. Well, what can you do? It happens, mistakes is happening for everyone. It doesn't matter how skilled you are in the game, how much knowledge you have. It is happening for literally everyone. And my biggest enemy, my lovely friends, it is my greediness. It's okay, it happens. Defeat is defeat. I made a mistake. I paid the price, right? Anyways, it was not a horrible game, but it could be so much better, right? Let's go for another one, and I am looking into the list, what we are going to play next, and we are going to play T57 next. This is for tomorrow's daily dose of skill. If you are wondering what the bloody F you are doing skill, why you are playing with so many different tanks and everything, fellas, there is a list in the as a first pinned comment or in the description where you can click on the list, and first thing which you will see summary, and if you would click on the second page or how it's called, the second section, you would see YouTube. You can find any YouTube video you want. For example, skill I want to see 907, there is even date when the game was made, and you can see literally everything right here. So use it, it's going to be in your advantage. And if you feel like I want to see 432 gameplay, now you are seeing 432 gameplay like nothing. It's very, very easy to use, fellas. And believe me, I did that not for myself. We did that for you. This idea is Skylar's idea, and Lurker helped us a bit. Lurker, I know from time to time you are watching this, so thank you. Okay, so what we are going to do right here, slowly but surely we will advancing in the city. We will take this hold down position and we are going to simply chill there just like this. We are going to flex our biceps and we are going to wait until the enemies are going to make one or another mistake. That's what we want to do, fellas. There is no rush for us. We have simply all time in the world of tanks, right? So this is the most important thing. I truly like this heavy tank, fellas. At first I did not really like it, but when I learned how to use the armor properly on this vehicle, holy bananas from Banana Land, it's not that bad as a tank overall. It's not bad. Patience. So right here, this map is called Siegfried Line, right? The thing is, in a way, this map can be called you push, you lose. Because if you are advancing way too far and after that enemies are going to make a hardcore pressure for you like this, you are going to have a terrible, terrible, terrible time, okay? So keep this in mind, fellas. This is the thing. So I want to do the things properly right here. I want to simply punish enemies for their stupidity instead of getting punished myself. And as you can see, it's working relatively well. Meanwhile, enemy Tishkevich is thinking about advancing forward, and if he is going to do that or she is going to do that, he is going to take one for the team, right? Schnei one for the team, tracking shot, beautiful, 1,600 damage as a start. Plus on top of that, this guy is going to sit in the big shithole. By the way, if you are wondering why did I said she, because Tishkevich is the women surname translated from the Polish language, right? How do I know that? I'm a hacker, okay? So stop complaining. Good, good. Tishkevich just took one for the team. We started this battle with a 2000 flat, which is completely fine. And all we need to do now, we need to be patient. We are holding our angle, we are holding our position, and I don't see any chance how we could advance. Obviously, we could go like this, but then T62A in the side, it's just simply not worth it. Sometimes patience is the best thing what we could actually do, or what we could have, right? So chill, relax, take it easy. If we will feel like enemies are losing this battle completely, what we are going to do, my lovely friends, then we are going to start making a bit of pressure. And you know what? I have a feeling enemies is actually losing this battle completely. Meanwhile, fellas, pay attention at our STB, right? Our STB had a crossfire into their T-62A, so he died. What we want to do now? Now we want to make a bit of pressure for those guys over there. 600 in the face, which is very good. Plus, on top of that, we have a bushwhanker in the back, which is completely fine. We are trying to make the angle right here, which is working very, very fine. And this guy is dead. Now what we need to do? We need to punish this guy into the lower plate. 600 in the face, beautiful. Plus, on top of that, he's down to one shotable. Meanwhile, what is happening? The Borshik is sitting right here and he's shooting high explosives. Where exactly Borshik is sitting at? You see this position over there, right here. So we are going to go with a blind shot with a high explosives in 3-2-1 now. Beautiful. Probably this is not a hit, so we are going to go once again, because I have a feeling we can actually punish him right here very, very hardly, okay? So chill, relax, take it easy. We have all time in the world of tanks and we are peeking once again. Now we are going to shoot over there. Schnei. This is definitely not a hit. And last one. Third shot is the charm and maybe it's going to work in our favor, right? So wait 5 seconds and then we are going to hit this guy over there. Meanwhile, the E-75 spotted us. I don't really mind and I don't really care. Going for a blind shot right there and definitely not a hit. Oh well, what can you do? Better luck next time, right? So, now we need to figure out how we could advance. How we could advance without getting punished for our stupidity or for our aggression, for our pressure after all, right? So what we are going to do, we are going to pre-aim to this Lorraine. And this Lorraine is not... this Lorraine is afraid, he's paranoid. He doesn't want to go in front. Well, okay. Not a big deal. How about if we would deal with this E-75 TS right here? Yep, I'm making the impenetrable angle right there. And this E-75 TS is a smart cookie. He is not trying to shoot us over there, which is completely fine, right? Meanwhile, he's getting tracked and now we are going in front right there. What do I want to do? I want to hit the Lorraine because he have more hit points and he's on the reload. So as you can see, both of them is down to one shotable. So now I'm loading high explosives. You might wonder, but skill, Borshik, last victim. I know the bush where he was in. I mean, that would be silly not to load high explosives. So now just wait for it until he's going to get spotted over there. Wait for it, wait for it, wait for it, wait for it. And Borshik is right there. Aha, smart Borshik, smart cookie. And he got pregnant from our Jack Pizda. Beautiful game. 4,300 damage, 400 assisting damage. We played safely without taking pretty much any risks whatsoever. And that worked extremely good for us. Too bad our team was too strong and they simply eliminated enemies without even asking their name. Also, I have a feeling this pawn which we actually had is a bit stronger than enemy's pawn, okay? At least that's what I think. But once again, it's only me. Beautiful battle, I'm very happy with it. 4,300 damage, 400 average assisting damage right there. By the way, quick reminding about yesterday's session with a 432. 1,200 damage. That was a great battle. But with Tishkevich, we slided from the hill, we got gangbanged by the three enemy vehicles, but we still managed to get a decent performance. 4,200 damage and 800 average assisting damage. It's not decent performance, sorry, it is amazing performance. I'm very, very happy with it and that worked very, very well. So here you go. This is quite good vehicle, I really like it. It is unique in a way because there is pretty much no tanks which would have 560 alpha damage. Skill, you have no knowledge of the game. There is tank which have 560 damage. Chetai said, stop complaining. So, thank you so much for watching, my lovely friends. I hope you had a blast by watching because I enjoyed playing it. I am feeling alive once again. I'm feeling good. I'm coming back on track. It is just beautiful, fellas. I am feeling very, very happy. Thank you so much for watching. See you next time, fellas. That was your daily dose of skill. Peace.